Hey guys, we're back. We're gonna teach you how to play jungle Rengar. Real quickly, let's go over what my team has against their team. We're gonna start off boots 3. So top lane, we have Kali versus their Jax. Akali has a lot of burrs. Jax is kind of, I wouldn't say weak early game, but he's not at his best. Akali's really strong at 6, so Akali could win that lane. Plus her stealth is really annoying. So that'll be a pretty fun lane. Middle we have Orianna versus their Cassiopeia. Cassiopeia is a really strong champion all around, but I think she has a pretty high skill cap, so down here in 1200 Elo, I don't think that she's going to be very good. But so does Orianna, so it's going to be kind of a who has the most skill is going to win that lane, I think. But Cassiopeia's ult is really a OP in 1v1, so we'll see. Bot lane, we have Lux Ezreal, which is a nice damage kill lane, versus Sona and ADTF. So I'm obviously, I don't like ADTF, so I'm going to put money on our lane for winning that one. And then jungle, we have I'm Rengar versus their Evelynn. Evelynn has really good ganks with her stealth. Rengar basically has the same thing at level 6, but up until then, he just has to rely on bush ganks or just walking out and bolo shotting or whatever. So, both have really good ganks. I think Rengar has more CC, maybe a little bit more burst, but not too much. Evelynn has good burst. I don't know why everybody's a blue. Yeah, wait, Evelynn has no escape. Oh, she has exhaust. Wraith. Too sad. Alright, so I'm not getting a really good leash this game. Yeah, whatever. Shit, almost died. Alright, so we're gonna pop both my health pots if we wanna get up. We're gonna early gank Jax. I like to level 2 gank when I'm topside. It's really just awesome. Healthbot's healing us back up, so we're good to go there. Alright, so he got his stun level 1, so I didn't get my Q off. Otherwise, I would have done a lot of damage to him. I would have double Q'd him. I probably should have bolo shot at him, but. Ah, whatever. Oh, wait. So bot just... Alright, so their bot just killed both of our bot players, so... That means ADTF's gonna have a big lead. I think? Did he get... Yeah, he got one. Yeah, that's something I got the other one. So I'm gonna have to go down bot soon already. No big deal. Okay. Maybe it's a big deal now. Everybody's dying. I would say Rengar's jungle speed is pretty slow early game. They usually start, you know, Wraith, go red, and then I'll early gank. I really like lane Rengar. I did it the other day. It's really, really strong. But here we're talking about jungle. So don't like completely shove the lane because you don't want to deny her all her farm. You just want to stop it, you know, get the extra ones. So Rengar's W is really good for jungling because it heals him when you have savagery up. So usually I would use that on the camps. I wouldn't use my Q unless I'm like red buff or something. Lesser creature. Oh god, there we go. Rengar doesn't need blue, but you want to take the early blue. You want to take the first blue for XP purposes, for sure. I think we're just gonna go Riggles. Just grab the damage. One ward, one pot. That's what I like to do. We're gonna head down. Gank on top. Jack stun. Oh, that was nice. That was slick. See, she didn't just run in a straight line because they would have just kept chasing. She, like, stopped for a second in her shroud and juked him. It's definitely what you want to do when you're playing Akali. I might be able to get this. Yep. Always use the bushes when you can. Alright, got the good gank there. And when you can, let your laners have the kills, because it really helps them with their gold, gets them ahead in lane. Alright, bottom really needs some love, but up. That's the top. Alright, we're gonna have to... I'm gonna go top since I'm already on this side, then I'm gonna start heading bot. Oh no, Akali's already gone, so... Just gonna have to watch the lane since Jack's pushing it right now. I'm just gonna kill the extra minions so they don't go to waste. And then I'm gonna probably start jungling my way down to bottom. Because Lux Ezreal is a really good combo that can help me out when I'm ganking a lot better. So I'm just going to jungle my way down. I'll be level 6 by the time I get down there. I should be full HP since his W with his savagery is really, really strong for lane sustain and for jungle sustain. Alright, so actually... I'm just putting off going bot, apparently. Before I'm going bot, red just spawned. Remember, 7:15, first buffs will spawn around that time, so I'm gonna get this. If you have an extra pot, just pop it, just to keep you up. Alright. So since Ezreal died, there's really nothing I mean, if I go down and gank, I can try to do something, but since he's dead, there's really nobody to back me up. So, one thing we're going to do right now is when you're playing as the opposing jungler, never mind. I was going to say, when we're playing as an opposing jungler, you want to... second. Can't focus. Alright, so... when you're playing against the opposing jungler, you want to watch where they are on the map. So, like, if she was bottom and I'm, like, around this area, I can go take her blue buff because she's so far away from it, there's nothing she can do about it. So, right now, since, I would just kill Evelyn, I'm going to take her blue buff because she needs blue buff. She doesn't need it, but it's really helpful for her. And plus, we can keep it off Cassiopeia so she can't spam her spells on Orianna. So always smite the enemy buff, don't forget that, we're always smiting the enemy buff because you don't want to be in their jungle too long, you don't want to risk death. So we're going to smite that. I'm going to see where Jax is up here. There's nothing to do up here anymore. So we're going to head down to our blue, it's going to spawn soon. And we're going to give it to Orianna since I already have their blue. So always smite their blue, and give your blue to your mid. Very important. If you have a mid that doesn't need blue, like Katarina or something, I mean, you could offer it to bot lane. You'd be like, hey, Ezreal, do you want blue or something like that? But if they don't really respond or they're not paying attention, then just take it for XP. Because everybody in lane is getting constant XP. You have to jungle, swap between ganks and jungle and stuff like that. So, like right now, I'm pretty ahead. But catch the trail. No.
Comfort breeds weakness.
like I said, I usually use my savagery on Battle Roar in the jungle, just because good jungle sustain, AoE damage, etc. On buffs, I'll usually use it on the Q, except for right there. Watch your savagery bar, don't mess up like I just did. Alright, I really gotta go by, like this is, I'm like really messing up here. So, because Ezreal just died, and I'm planning on ganking bot, I'm just going to go back, I'm going to grab some damage, grab a Wriggles, grab Boots of Mobility, great for ganking, grab another ward and a health pot, and we're going to go, and we're going to just come down and gank bottom. So he may have just been paying attention and saw me coming down, TF that is, because he just ulted. Not sure, we'll see. Because lane ganking with Rengar is really, really effective because he can jump all the way. Like, a huge distance, so. Savagery's at 2. So you can combo your flash with your ultimate to get that jump. Because you don't always want to let those kills get away. Okay, I'm getting way too many kills. I didn't mean to do that. Like, I just wanted to rune him down, but I wasn't, like, really paying attention to his health. Alright, so since we just killed bot lane, we're gonna push this tower. Get some damage going. Evelynn's gonna try to be a threat. I don't really... She's not doing that much damage. I always try to ward as the jungler, just because you're everywhere on the map, you always want to keep warding for your team. Like right now, I just warded everywhere for bot, so they should be fine. Orianna looks like she's doing a lot better. She's got blue buff, she's really pushing against Cass. Top needs some love, so I'm gonna grab my jungle, my topside jungle to get some XP. And we're gonna head over to Jax. Oh right, I didn't even notice if you had oracles. Okay. So my wards just got taken out. That sucks, but... I'm gonna save my savagery stacks because I have Wriggle, so it'll die fast enough as it is. We're maxing Q first, so if you guys haven't been noticing, we're gonna max Q first, and then what you get as a second spell is up to you. If you're gonna gank at level 2, get your Bola shot. If you're going to just want to, other than like just pure single target damage, you want to get your. You want to get your Battle Roar maxed out next. That's what I usually do, is I max the Battle Roar. So we know this isn't warded because we have a pink ward here. Alright, so I was going to ult, but Akali has an ult that closes gaps anyway, so... So now what we're going to do, since we have 4 or 5 stacks, we're going to double Q the tower. A lot of damage comes from that. He's always there. See, if you can see that lanes are going to be pushed or something really hard, go help out your lanes. Like, Eve's doing that really well. I didn't think Akali wanted to do that. Alright. So if we can kill that Eve, then that Oracle's is gone. Which is really not smart of her to get that Oracle's, because it's kind of hard to catch Eve sometimes because of her stealth and her movement speed and stuff. So I wasn't watching where Cass went, but I think what we're going to do is we're going to gank bottom again. I got red buffs this time, so we'll give you more damage. If they had tower dived that, I would have came out, but I didn't really want to show myself right there. So Orianna's there. I think they saw that because they have that river warded. So. If this Ezreal can push, then I can just run in to the bush there. Actually, so they had a pink ward, so they saw my ward up there. I'm just gonna leave it for now. They have the whole area warded, so. I don't think they're doing dragon. Yeah, they're just playing the ward. Alright, so just to make sure, like when you're clicking around, that you don't accidentally kill blue, just hold down S and you'll just stand there like that and you won't hit it. So that's the thing you want to do instead, because, you know, everyone hates that when the person hits it and Riggles kills it or something like that and they don't get the blue. That's just unnecessary, you know, messing up. That can easily be prevented. Alright, so we're going to try ganking bot one more time. The minions are a little bit more pushed up this time. I'm just gonna run in. Falls deep. Let's do it. If he kills that, oh jeez. You know, going balls deep. Balls deep. Balls deep. So I used my bullet shot passive there to root her down. Unfortunately, it's sewn up, so she ulted us and just ran away. Ooh. I'm staying right around here just so that she doesn't walk out and kill them without me seeing her first, because of her, I can see her if she's close. I think that's where he wants to stay. She tries to NCS. I don't really. Okay, so Evelyn's mid, so I don't really need to be here anymore. Just kidding, Ezreal's gonna die. Nah, it's okay. So he's gonna farm a tower. ADTF. He's doing okay for him. So, I haven't really been giving a lot of love. Or I wasn't really. He was doing good. I think Ezreal will just outscale him, really. So we got Cassiopeia, like, moving away from her lane, moving away from her safety, so we're gonna head over there.
The scent of prey.
I think they might be doing dragon, or they're gonna come gank bot and then do dragon. Yeah, probably the latter. Yep. So Evelyn's in the area as well, so we're gonna just kind of peel off over here. Yep, there's Evelyn. Because it's going to be a 4-on-4 right now. Okay, so we got Evelyn's Oracles. That was good. Alright, so Cass is still up here, so we're gonna make a pay for that. Alright, so we need the high burst, so we're going to pop our ult, get the Savagery stacks up. Oh, he had a stun charge. I'm just gonna back off. Because he can burst me. I'm not really that tanky at all. I have his Riggles.
There is the hunter and the hunting.
So I got 2600 gold. I probably should have gone back a long time ago. We need to. You want to keep going back as frequently as necessary. Jax is right there. If she had run into that bush, I would have been so screwed. We're gonna get a bone tooth necklace just because it's really, really good on Rengar because it's his individual item. It's just like Magi Steel Stealer or whatever, it scales off kills. And right now I'm 5-0-3, so I'm getting kills and assists, so that's a really good item to have. I like to go Frozen Mallet next on Rengar. Just because he needs to be a tankier character. I'll grab a ward. 2 health pots just because I'm taking some damage. So if you pop a health pot while you're in the middle of a fight, it really does a lot. It does help a lot. You'd be surprised. Alright, so they're gonna contest Dragon right now. They might get it, we'll see. I have my smite up, I have my ult up. Alright, so Evelyn got that. I'm gonna ult away. Alright, he got me, but we got 2-3 for Dragon. If we get this Evelyn, it'll be great. It'll be way better than what they got. I think we might get it if this Lux hits it. Yep, she hit it. Come on. Got it, alright. So the only person that lived is Cassiopeia. Oh, Cassiopeia lived? Oh no, she died. Sona lived. So Sona's guarding bot. So they pushed mid. So they took Dragon, but we got 4-5 kills now and a tower. So that was way worth it for us. Like, that was not even worth it for them. I probably could have smite stole that. Those frames lagging a little bit and I didn't really get a good target on the Dragon, but 2 towers now. So because they went and took Dragon and we killed them, we got all 5 of them, we killed them all. And we got 2 outside towers. That's an amazing trade for us. I'm going to be freak right now. I'm going to say that was a phenomenal trade. So focusing more on Rengar. I kind of went with Boots of Mobility because it's great for Rengar, for ganking, along with his bush jumping. Oh, Kali died. So I went with Wriggles. I'm getting Frozen Mallet after getting the Bowtooth Necklace. You know, just going with the tankier damage builds. You want to, and as I've been saying all game, you want to look around where everybody is on the map and respond to that accordingly. This Jax has an Oracles, if you notice, but he hasn't popped it yet. So Jax is really strong, so I don't think I can really fight him, but I can just hold the lane. I can hold the lane forever just with my savagery W heal. No big deal. Rengar can take Jax. Yeah, Rengar's definitely a very strong champion, especially with the most recent buff. Really good. So apparently, well, that's true. You can get a Triforce or you can get a Frozen Mallet. I just like Frozen Mallet because of the slow. I mean, Triforce has a slow as well, but the health and beefiness is really useful. I think I'm still gonna get a Frozen Mallet. I just like the idea of it better. Try not to let any minions go to waste on the tower, for sure. Alright, so if you notice, I went into the bush here, and because of our ward I had vision, I just jumped onto him to initiate. You don't always have to use your ult to initiate, I don't like to. I like to save it for escapes, or like, you know, save it for an escape if you're getting focused, and then just turn around and come back in once you have full savagery and burst them again. It's great to do that. So because we just killed 3 of them, we're going to push mid again. We can take this mid tower. Because the only ones left up is Sona and AD Twisted Fate, so I don't really think either of them are going to stop me and Orianna from doing this. I mean, he could try. He could stun me just to stop my damage like he's going to do, but it's not really going to stop me completely. so I took some extra damage, but I know that he doesn't really have the kill potential to finish it. Let me check their blue. No. Oh wait, maybe. Alright, so they're gonna get into a brawl. No, we don't want that. See, the teams, when you're playing with your team, you want to make sure that you, after you do something good, you don't want to linger too long, because once they're dead and they come back, they're going to be stronger, they have more items, and you're going to be weaker because you just got into a fight with them. So you always want to, like, you know, if you're going to do something, do it and get out. Like, I've seen so many teams, like, what happened down there, where they were all kind of, like, looking at each other. I've seen my team, like, engage, and they would just die because, you know, they have no idea what they're doing. Alright, so he was really committed to that tower, it looks like. So they got a tower. That was a better trade for them in the long run, but I mean, with the towers that we've taken, we're so far ahead of them in towers that kill probably was worth more for us than that tower was for them. Our team's kind of snowballing the bottom now. Oh, Ezreal just got caught with that. But I mean, if you look at that Lux support, I mean, she's fed. She has so much damage. She's 0-2 and 9. She doesn't even have that many items, but she's doing a lot of burst damage because we're so far ahead of them right now. And that's your main thing to do as a jungler. Now, I'm not saying I did it because I was kind of slack in this game. Sorry about that. But what you want to do is you want to force your team to carry. Like, they don't have a choice. They're going to carry this game. So you have to go to every lane. Let your lanes get the kills and just keep ganking every lane while staying up in XP and stuff. And you're just gonna, like, force them to carry.
A true hunter never rests.
So we were waiting for Jax here. So I use my flash to close the gap there. You can always juke like that. Just kidding. That didn't work. That's okay. So try not to be too cocky when you're ahead and die like that. Like me and her were trying to, like, 2v5. But while we were doing that, we're pushing bottom. So we're gonna get a good tower. We're gonna get a tower off of that. That's good. Always good to keep pushing the lanes because we have pressure everywhere, so it's going to be a lot easier to take objectives like Dragon and Baron. Like, they're not going to come over here and stop this. They have to guard the tower. They have to guard the lanes. I mean, they can't stop us. Now, I never really looked at, like, a guide on how to build Rengar or anything. I just kind of wing it. But, so, Boots of Mobility and Wriggles, top two, to get to start, right? Bone Tooth Necklace really goes well with him if you're doing well. If you're not, I wouldn't say get it if you're not going to get any kills or assists, but if it's like, even if you're like half and half, get it, just because it'll help you snowball. And then get a Frozen Mallet, or Trinity Force, your preference. You could get a Warmogs to be more tanky if you get the Trinity Force. Guardian Angel is never a bad item on Rengar, you could get that. You could get an early couple Doran's Blades if you wanted to. Last Wish was really good. I'm going to go Bloodthirster just because I love this. I love the damage on Rengar. And it's just awesome because now I'm already healthy, you know, I'm already beefy because of Frozen Mallet, and the Bloodthirster would really help my spike damage. I haven't really been warding. I ward a lot more on Maokai than I do on Rengar. I'm all about damage on Rengar, but you still want to ward it some. You still want to ward somewhat, even if you're not gonna, like, ward all the time. So we got level 3 ult, which is nice. Yeah, I wouldn't really say you need too much attack speed on Rengar, just because his double Q is just crazy for attack speed. Alright, so now, let's take a look at where they are on the map. Where do you notice they all are? Because we have wards, don't keep in mind, we know where they are. They're all in this general area. So we can really force Baron right now. Jax is bought. We'll see, Ezreal needs to come with us. He's gonna... I guess he's he wants to stop Jax. So I don't think we can really Baron this. Especially now that we just cleared a ward, they know we're in this area. So we could try to bait it. See Cassiopeia's like maybe coming out, maybe not. Ez got Jax, that's nice. If you notice, I made Sona use her ult just on me. Okay, so Cass got me there. I kept going when the team wanted to back, so that's kind of what I get, but... So Ez is just going to keep pushing bottom. I mean, just because he went to go stop Jax doesn't mean that he's, like, a bad player or anything because he didn't come to Baron with us. He killed Jax, and now he's just going to keep, you know, pushing bottom, putting a lot of pressure, while Lux can put pressure on mid against Cassiopeia. So we have pressure in two lanes. So that's really good for pushing. And Ezreal's going to get a tower out of that. So you know what? I'd say that was a pretty good trade for us. We got four kills for three, and we got a tower. So you know what? Good trade overall. So basically, as Rengar, it's a, your role is a little bit different than if you were, maybe I shouldn't have bought that, but whatever. If you're dying, don't buy oracles. If you're somewhat living, then buy it, but... So, what was I just saying? As Rengar, your role in teamfights is a little bit different than Maokai. Maokai, you know, you're a big AoE damage reduction tank, and you stay and protect your team. Rengar, on the other hand, is very, very high spike damage jungler. Very high spike damage. Especially if you build him somewhat tanky, he can get into your backline and just rip apart your squishies. And you can do that through your ult, or you can do that by fighting in a bushy area and just jump over everybody into the squishies. And then you can use your ult to get out and come back in to get another row of squishies or something like that. But his main role is definitely getting the squishies. That's what he's all about. So, they're going to push mid, it looks like? Yeah, they want to push mid. So we're going to come up around. We don't want to let them have a free tower. So, we're going to stop that. Team's kind of wandering in their bottom jungle. We could come up and force Baron with Jax down. I think what we're going to do is we're going to push mid. Oh, yep. So we got something going on here. I'm going to ult because it gives me a movement speed increase. And go right for Evelyn. Right on the squish, he's gonna flash for that cast. Alright, I didn't get really get anything on the cast, but... Okay, so in this situation, even if it's like wasn't such a clear, decisive victory in that team fight, you have to pick, do you want to push or do you want to go Baron? And right now, you know what? We could just win the game, which I think is what we're gonna do. Because you always want to go for that, you just want to win the game when you can. Like, don't try to prolong it just because you're winning. Because I've seen that happen where people are like, oh, not sure what that's always, but, alright. So, I don't know why I was clicking elsewhere and it didn't go there, but, you have to, I've seen people like really ahead, so they try to prolong the game just to get more kills and they lose the game. So you want to just win it, like shut it down, win it when you can. Yeah, so playing Rengar, things to remember. He's kind of slow jungler at the beginning, so take it easy. Try to jungle fast and keep on ganking, but, you know, you can only do what you can. Early ganking is what Rengar is really strong at because of his bush jumping abilities. He's because of that, he's not the best ganker for mid because he can't jump to the middle of the lane. The distance is too big. But if they're hugging one side, you can use that to your advantage. Bot is usually warded in the lane in, or in the bush area through the river, so you can't always do that unless you get an oracles. And top is always a really good gank unless it's warded. Lane ganks in top and bottom, really good with Rengar because he can just jump from the bushes. Let's see what else. Team fights, get the squishies. That's your main goal. Find who's carrying their team and kill them instantly because you have that kit to do that. You can just go walk right by them with your ult and crush them. Or if you have savagery stacked pre-fight, and you're in a bushy area, jump, double Q them, take as much damage as you can before they start like really starting to focus you, because you're in behind them. Ult, get out, wait for the savagery to stack back up because of your ult, and then jump back in and double Q again. And if they're not dead by then, they're so far ahead of you that you shouldn't win the game. But so build, boots of mobility and wriggles, heart, then a bone tooth necklace if you're half and half or ahead, frozen mallet or trinity force, and then you can go tankier. You can get a warmox, you can get a guardian angel, or you know, you can get a Randuin's Omen, you can get a heart of gold earlier too. You can get, I mean, it really depends. Like, if you don't have a tank on your team, and your team is kind of like, you need a tank to win, then build tank. But, I mean, you want to have some damage. Like, your Wriggles will be damagey. Frozen Mallet is damagey. You always want to have tanky items. If you really want to snowball and you're ahead, get, like, a Bloodthirster, like I did, because I was snowballing, I was ahead. You can get a ton of damage. You can do whatever. So, thanks for watching. This is my How to Play Rengar guide, and I hope you guys like, rate, subscribe, and I'll keep the videos coming.